Welcome to the Winter with Turtle and Beaver puppet show.
One day, the turtle was sitting on a beaver lodge while sunning himself. Brr, it's getting chilly outside. I can feel that cold north wind. Even the sun doesn't warm me like it did this summer. Beaver came out and said, "Hey, who is that? Who said you could sun yourself on my lodge?" The turtle said, "I'm sorry, Beaver. I hope you don't mind. I had to get out of the cold water and into the sun. I'm freezing. I'm so cold, I'm thinking of going into hibernation." Beaver said, "Listen to me, Turtle. You can't sleep your winters away like that. Look at me. I stay active and keep warm by huddling with my family in the lodge. Why, right now I'm cutting branches and sticks and putting them into the mud underwater so we have some nice, juicy bark to eat when the pond freezes over. Then I gotta repair the lodge and fix a leak in the dam. I'm busy, busy, busy. How can you even think of sleeping?" Turtle replied, "Beaver, you may have your own body heat and a nice thick fur coat to hold it in, but I'm just a cold-blooded terrapin with nothing but the shell on my back for my home. I must burrow deep into the mud to sleep off the winter. If I tried to stay awake, I would freeze and die." Suddenly, a red-winged blackbird flew in. "Look at me! Look at me!" Beaver says, "Oh, cool it, Red Wing. We know you're there already." Red Wing replies, "Beaver, is that you? Why are you in such a bad mood?" Beaver replies, "It's my teeth. I bit into the bark of the tree I cut down over there, and some human had driven a nail into it, and I chipped my tooth. Ouch! It hurts!" Suddenly, a honeybee flew in, buzzing. "I'm glad he's gone. Old Red Wing might just eat me up." Beaver, "I suppose you came here to brag about flying south for the winter, too." "No, Beaver. You're in a lousy mood. I'm not the boastful type. Besides, all we honeybees do is ball up together in our hollow tree to help each other keep warm when Old Man Winter arrives." "Hey," the beaver says, "it's kind of like how we are when we snuggle together in our lodge." Honeybee replied, "Well, sort of, although I'd rather have my stinger than your flat tail any day." Beaver replied, "I wouldn't mind having a stinger myself. There are a few times I would have used it, I'll tell you, but I couldn't use a stinger to help me pack mud into my lodge and my dam." Honeybee replied, "Oh, Beaver, I'd like to talk, but I'm very busy gathering nectar to make our winter honey supply. Easy does it with that tooth." And he flew away. Turtle replied, "Hey, Beaver, I heard the way you were talking to Honeybee. You seem quite convinced that your way of doing things is the only right way. How about a little humility?" Beaver replied, "Oh, I've been so foolish. I never had any idea there were so many ways to survive the winter," Beaver said. "Now I know I feel lucky to have it so easy and to have my family to help me through it." Turtle says, "I'm glad you've come to your senses. It's time to look for a good spot in the mud to sleep the winter away. So long, Beaver." "Take it slow, Turtle," says the beaver as he starts to walk away. "Oh, very funny, Beaver. Very funny."
The end. Thanks for watching our show.